This is Nicholas the Axeman. You're watching Dante's Boxing Nation. Boom!
Now they're talking about Lomachenko favorite. Oh, I love that. They will see come Saturday.
They're going to see.
Play around with this thing, man. The thing is a play around thing, this. Boxing is a very serious game. No play around about who is who.
Nope.
Boxing is a top man, and they should respect that and don't try to carry it like they are. He's way away from that. Oh, he's below the Axeman, man. He's not no damn higher. Well, come Saturday, they will see. And from the first round, I told him with Daniel Trino, we get China, they would blah blah. I said, when the first round, look at Daniel's face, you will see that it's not like that. And I'm no damn ordinary coach like no other coach either. I'm not don't mix with a lot of coach, man. If I train Lomachenko, you'll see that he's just started to damn box. He know nothing. It's not a broad thing, man. This is a knowing thing. I know this sport, and I'm ahead of them with anything. And when this bell goes bang, they will see what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Is that a play role, man?
Some of the fans are infatuated almost in love with Lomachenko's angles, his speed, and they say there's no way Nicholas Walters can deal with his angles, his speed. He has 400 wins in the amateurs and one loss. What do you say to the fans to say that?
Listen, they don't understand boxing. Boxing is one of the most complete games. It's such a hard game to understand. The Muhammad Ali will tell you if you could get the brain of Ali, if you could get in that brain to see how he does it. He fight Foreman, they say, oh, he's going to fight for it. He's fight Fraser. It's not like that, man. When those boxers get in the ring, all his foot speed, all the hand speed, it's totally different when the fighter is clever. You're not going to see that Lomachenko, a weak guy, drop the hand and pose and not like that with Axeman, and Axeman will know that what he does to other fighters, he's not going to be able to do it with Lomachenko either. It's a total different business when these two work. And I can bet you Lomachenko, when that bell rung and they do one round, he's going to realize that, oh, it's a quite different thing. It's not that you can bam bam, you throw 6 punch and that guy don't answer. You can brag, you can do what it is. But when you throw 1 punch and the guy answer, and you throw, it happened to my boy too, when he fought Sosa. I was telling him in all the training that he was so high that he didn't want to do a lot of what I want him to do. But I know when he stepped to that stage, because he was fighting 126. He had the power, so he could get rid of his opponent. Now he stepped up in the weight, I know that would make a difference. This guy would take more punch, and I know that. But he was cocky a bit, and then even just when we come here, he said, "Dad, I will never test you again about what you're saying. Because if I had listened to you, I'd have knocked so. But I just think I would." But then I realized the difference between the weight.
Mm-hmm.
So when Lomachenko talk about this foot, and those people talk about foot movement, oh, your foot movement with those other people. Not with the man who is that ice, that smart.
Mm-hmm.
Because remember, you prepare your weapons. And if that weapon taken away from you, you better have more to go for. And that is what's going to happen. I'm telling you, you're going to see it come Saturday night. It's not a doubt that you're going to see it.
Okay. Thanks, man.
Yes.
Does he? One more last thing. Does he feel stronger at 126? He feel more comfortable at the weight than 122?
I don't think weight has nothing to do with the Axeman. I don't think weight has nothing to do. It's just a cockiness of, because he stepped into a new dimension. I have been there, I understand the older person. He's young and didn't understand. Now he's at 120, 30. He do understand what I was saying about the boy have a few more pounds on that. When he was at that weight, bam, bam, and they would respond to those shots, he step up, he realize, and he gets it in his brain that yes, he does done that a little more. So you will see. He understand it now. And when he go to another weight, I'm not going to get the problem like what I get when he moves up to 130. If he moves up to, I think we have to go to other weight now. Because there's nobody going to, who next? When he don't finish Lomachenko, who next?
Mm-hmm.
I don't see. If you see all who is fight, they don't want to have no rematch.
Mm-hmm.
The only body want, everybody is who fight like Axeman. Fight those, so they want rematch. No rematch with the Axeman, man.
No rematch.
Yeah,
they're not going to want it, huh?
He beats them up. He don't want to thump them. He beats them up.